Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's video. And now guys, today's video is going to be some kind of a story time video, but it's going to be like two stories in one video. One is the story about how I got arrested. Guys, yes, I got arrested. I have been arrested once in my life and I'm going to tell you guys a story. And then the second story is going to be my most embarrassing, my most embarrassing moment in life. So yeah, I am super excited for this video, and if this is something you will enjoy watching, then please keep on watching. Okay, so the very first story about how I got arrested, don't worry guys, this is not a very recent story. Like, this didn't just happen to me recently. It happened while I was in the university, and yeah, I will tell you guys all about it. So while I was in the university, I had a school boyfriend back in uni. And honestly, before I started dating Jesse, that was like my longest relationship ever. If you don't know, I went to University of Nigeria in Nsukka. So yes, I am a lioness, a proud lioness. Okay, so I went to UNN and I had somebody I was dating for the most part of my stay in the university. On this particular evening / night, we went to a place on campus called Chitties. If you're familiar with Enugu, you're familiar with, you know, UNN and Enugu in general, Chitties is like an eatery, a popular eatery. So they had come to UNN, they opened a branch in UNN, and everybody was always flocking in there. You know, they had really good pastry at the time. So if a guy wants to take you to somewhere nice, they take you to Chitties at that time. And yeah, on this particular evening / night, my boyfriend and I, and I think one of his roommates or his friends, I can't even remember who was with us that day. I can't remember. Nigeria was playing. Was it Nigeria match? There was a match, Sha, that day. And and this story is so funny. If you know me, I am not really a football person per se, but back then in uni, when you have a boyfriend who digs such stuff, you tend to always, and even him, he wasn't really into like football like that, but I think that evening was a major match. I think it was either a World Cup going on or something, and it was a quite important match. So most students didn't really have like DSTV and stuff that time. Most times you'd find where to go and watch the match, maybe like a staff house or, you know, any other restaurant or eatery that is, you know, viewing that particular event on TV. So on this particular day, Chitties was, you know, showing this match, and that was like the closest place that we could go to go and watch this match. And for some reason, I remember very well that I didn't really want to go out that evening. Like, I didn't feel like going out that evening, quite honestly. But somehow he just talked me into it. What will you be doing here? Let's just go, you know, to be a nice evening out, blah blah blah. So we went to Chitties, and bear in mind that when we got there, we didn't even order anything, we didn't buy anything, we were just there to watch the match, which I will tell you guys right now, don't do that. Okay, if you're going anywhere to watch anything or do anything, it'd be like a restaurant that actually sells stuff, please buy something. Okay, so we had sat down in front of the television with other people who were also waiting to watch this match, and we're waiting for the match to start. I think the match even started. Then the manager of the place, obviously, you know, went round, and you know, the place was actually getting crowded. People were coming in there to watch this match without buying anything. So the guy was like, see, if you people must stay here and watch this, you must buy something. Even if it's at least a bottle of Coke, you must buy something, you know. A lot of students either were broke, didn't have money. You know how student life can be. Some maybe just bought Coke, some bought meat pie, you know, stuff like that. Some I did not even have. Even me, I think at that particular time, I was even very broke. I didn't have any money on me to even buy anything. And neither did my boyfriend at the time, so. So the very first time the manager actually came to us, tell us to buy something, we just ignored him like, I beg, last, we'll still watch this match, you understand? And then later on, they came to remind us again that if we're not going to buy anything, they would have to tell us to leave and everything. Then we just shot ignored. Then the third time again, they came, and I don't know who got angry now, it couldn't have been me, it's obviously not me. Either my boyfriend got angry or it was his friend. Somebody got angry, I can't remember, like somebody just lost it and like got up. I was like, what is it? We come here all the time, we buy things on this particular day, now we must buy something, so we don't want to buy, and they're stopping us, you know. He went on full haywire mode. I don't think he was, I can't remember who got upset, honestly. I
think it was my boyfriend though.
Yes, I think he got angry. Like, he was the one. He flared up. He said, I beg, let's even get out from this place. What is even in this place? Said, we got up and then he said, let's go. And then we were walking out. And then I think he was just so angry and he was just so mad. We walked out. At that point, I was so scared because I'm just like, hey, I'm not about to die here today, okay? You know, my mother and father, they still love me so much. I'm not about to die here. And then we just walked out of the place in anger. He walked out. Me, I couldn't be bothered because me said, what's to consign me, consign the match like that, you know? So I think we're just taking a walk back to the house. And then before we could say Jack, there was a van that pulled up behind us. And in UNN, if you went to UNN, we had a very active security presence in UNN. They are called the security department. So they're like, they arrest people, cultists, you know, they shall arrest. They can arrest you and all of that. And most times, if you're guilty of a very, very serious crime, you can be rusticated. Okay. So the van pulled up and said, were you the people that just left Chitis now? We said, we're the people that left Chitis. Okay. Enter inside the van. Yeah. I say, wait. Enter inside the van. This is security department. Enter inside the van. I say, Jesus. Is this how I'm going to end up? Is this what is going to become of me? I'm not going to be that girl that security arrested and they will now rusticate over something that our boyfriend did. No, this cannot be me. This was like night, guys. This was like 7 p.m., 7:30 p.m.-ish, around that time. That was how we entered security department's van, though, guys. They took us to their security department, gone, just before the school gate. We're trying to explain what happened and everything. Me, I was just quiet like a mouse. I was just like, I don't know what's going on. I'm just an acquaintance. I don't know what's happening. They gave us, you know, paper to write our statements and everything on what happened. My dear, it was not a small thing, no. It was not a small thing. I thought that was going to be the end of my stay in university because of man. But yeah, I don't even know how we got out of that mess that day, guys. But they took our statements, they're talking among themselves, blah, blah, blah. I think at some point we just started begging. I think it was just a matter of begging because at that point I could not imagine my image. Okay, not like I really had much of an image in quote, but I couldn't imagine, oh, this girl will now enter this kind of wahala, you know. So I think at the end of the day, we actually just begged our way out of it. I think we sha begged, and we're just like, oh, we didn't mean it or something, sha, because it could have gotten a lot more serious than that. And you don't, as a university student, you don't want your parents knowing that you've entered a kind of problem in school. They will ask you, what are you doing? Who are you with? You know, and all of that. But I think for some reason, we just begged our way out of it. I can't remember what we did. I think my boyfriend at the time called one of his friends that knew somebody in security department, something. And we were able to get out of that mess, guys. And we headed back home that night, like 9 p.m. We didn't get released until like 9 p.m. Guys, I was so scared because in my head, I was just like, hey, you know. I was so scared, but I was so happy when they let us go. And they warned us to stay out of trouble, that if they ever hear that any of us is in any trouble again in school, it's going to get a lot more serious than that. So you can be sure that for the better part of my remainder in that school, I tried not to get into any kind of problem. So yes, guys, that was a story about how I got arrested. That's like the one and only time I think I've gotten arrested. You know, I haven't been arrested by the Nigerian police or any other serious body, but that's like the one and only time I remember getting arrested. Okay, so down to my second story. My second story is going to be just a little story about the one time that I feel was like my most embarrassing moment. Many of us have our embarrassing moments in life. Like, we've all had so many embarrassing moments, and this particular story is peculiar because I can't really say it was an embarrassing moment because I don't know how many people saw me that day. I can't really say if anybody even saw me, but it was just super embarrassing. Now, if you don't know, I had a 9-to-5 job. Yes, I once worked a 9-to-5 job. If you're new on my channel, you might just be doing that for the very first time. I did work a 9-to-5 job sometime between 2012 and 2016 for 4 years. And where I was working, my office occupied, it was a 12th floor building, and my office occupied the ground floor, the 9th floor, the 7th floor, 3 floors, yeah, I think even the 5th floor at some point. And And on this particular day, I don't forget, it was a Friday, and on Fridays we wear our Ankara, you know. So I wore an Ankara top and skirt to work that day. And I got to the ground floor, obviously from the parking lot to the ground floor, and I was waiting to go into the elevator to take me to my own office, because my office at the time was on the 7th floor, I mean the 5th floor, one of them. So I was waiting to go into the elevator, and there were a couple of people that are also waiting, you know, for the elevator as well. We were quite a number, because that was like resumption time, so many people were actually by the elevator waiting for the elevator to come down. So guys, on that particular day I was on my period, and this is so cringy. You guys know how it is with women. Your first and second day of your period is like the heaviest days. And I think that was like my second day or something. So that was like one of the very heavy days, in fact. And on that particular day, you know, of course, I had, you know, I wore a pad. Then I was still using pads, you know, back to back. So I wore a pad that day. I was wearing an Ankara top and a matching Ankara skirt. And the next thing I felt was, I felt a hot trickle of liquid running down my legs. Like a hot trickle. When I mean hot trickle, you know how period blood can be. I'm sorry if this is grossing you out, but it can be quite hot when it's coming. Not like hot, like burning hot, but it's warm when it's coming out of your, you know, vagina. I felt that warm trickle running down my legs, and I closed my eyes for a second, and I was like, that cannot be happening to me right now. No, that cannot be happening to me right now. And I just looked down, guys, and indeed blood was actually trickling down my legs. I was wearing a skirt, not a trouser. This was a case of everybody, and I'm Oyibo, so imagine my Oyibo legs with red liquid. As in, I was like, okay, who else has seen this? Who else has seen this? Nobody. Okay, I quickly went left. Look at my hand. I went left like this, and then I ran up the staircase, because of course the building has staircases on either side, not just the elevator. So I took the staircase on the left and I sped up the staircase with speed. Though, don't know for the life of me if anybody downstairs saw that morning. Up till today, I don't know. But quite frankly, I was not willing to find out who actually saw. My own was to get out of there as soon as possible. So I ran onto the staircase. I ran as fast as my legs could carry me up to the 5th floor where my office was. I ran into the bathroom, guys, and there I saw that for some reason, I think the pants I wore that day was not tight enough, so there was a space between my pants and my leg and my pad. There was just a space, it was leaking out. Instead of leaking into the pad, it leaked out of that space and then down my legs. Guys, I can't begin to explain to you how I felt that day. I felt so, I don't know what's the word to use now. I felt like the whole world have seen my everything. That's how I felt. Okay. And I quickly, you know, cleaned myself up. There was tissue in the bathroom, so I used tissue, I used water. I cleaned myself up. During that time, I never really used to carry wipes around like that. I mean, now I carry wipes because I'm a mom. But then, I was not about that wipe life like that. So, I used tissue, I used water, I cleaned myself up. I didn't bring extra panties from home. And going home to go and change my panties was not an option, okay? So, I just literally had to. I don't know how I even managed for the rest of the day. But I was always conscious because my panties were not so tight. They were a bit loose. So, yeah. Till today, that is my most embarrassing moment. Like, I don't even know who and who saw, but it was my most embarrassing moment ever in life. So yeah guys, those are the two stories I have for you guys in this video. Hope you guys enjoyed watching a video like this. If you enjoyed watching, leave me a comment down below. Subscribe if you are not yet subscribed already. Thumbs up the video. What other kind of stories do you want me to tell you guys here on my channel? And yeah, leave it in the comment section below. I would definitely get to it. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Mwah.